Hello everyone, welcome to YellowGrey's. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your first test case in UiPath Studio. Before we start creating new test case projects, I will show you the process flow that we are going to use to create the test cases. Look at this process flow. I have created an initialized application process flow. This will trigger opening the Notepad application. I have provided the Notepad exe path in the argument that you can see in the argument panel. Then in the bot has to type the custom content like how to create your first test case. Then it's going to close the same Notepad by clicking on the close button. Then it's clicking on the don't save button. This is the process flow that we are going to use for test cases. Let me run this process. Look at this execution. The process steps are executed as per the designed workflow. Let's go and create a test case now. Go to project panel. In the project panel, right click on the workflow that you want to create a test case for and choose to create test case. Look at this new test case pop-up window. We have test case name and location, and also we have other two options, mark workflow under test and import mock template drop down list. Now it's in disabled mode. Do you guess why? Yes, we need to install the testing package in order to start creating test cases for this project. Let's close this window and go to manage package. Then click on all packages. In the search bar, type uipath.testing.activities, then select and click on install and click on the save button. Now look at the project dependency list. We have newly added UiPath testing dependency. Now go back to workflow, then right click on it and choose to create test case. Now look at the window, both the options are enabled. Add the test case name, init notepad test case. If you want to make a copy of workflow where you can mock specify activities, or if you have an existing mock file that you want to use, you can select it from the mock dropdown. Let me choose this to show you the mock workflow as well. Then click on next. If you want to add this data, you can add it here. As of now, we do not require test cases for this process. I will show you different use case to add the test data in the next tutorial. Now, click create. Look at the project panel. It's created a mock workflow for testing purpose, which is duplicate of the actual workflow. Let's double click on the test case which you created, and it has three blocks, given, when, and then. In the when block, the mock workflow file is invoked inside the invoke workflow file activity. Click on import arguments. We need to supply the application path here. Then in the given, we do not have any other pre-activity to run before start when. Okay, let's come to the point. What are the test cases you can create for this init application workflow? One is for application opened and completed all the steps successfully. That is success scenario. And another is you may get unable to open the application or unable to execute the process steps due to selector or system exceptions. That is failure scenario. Let me add this entire workflow into try catch block. Right click on the invoke workflow activity and click on surrounded with try catches. In the catches, add system.exceptions. Drag and drop assign activity into catches block. Create a variable to store the exception message and change the variable scope into the entire workflow. And add value exception.messages. Now come to then block, add test suite verification activity. I will drag and drop verify expression activity to make it simpler to this test case. So here in this expression, I'm going to write a simple expression. If the exception message is nothing, I have to say the test case is passed. If the exception message is not nothing, it contains any errors, I have to say that this case is failed. Let's execute this test case with a positive scenario. It's showing that test case is passed. In the text explore panel, you can see the activity coverage percentage and also you can see the test results. Now, I am going to run this workflow with a negative test scenario. For that, I will make changes to the application URL. Let me provide the incorrect URL, then run the test case. The execution is done. Look at this output window. The given test scenario is failed. This is how we test our individual workflow using UiPath Studio test suite activities. I hope you are clear with this demo. Next, we will see how to publish test cases to the orchestrator and how to convert workflow into a test case in the next tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and support. Connect with us for more tutorials.